Most people would agree that knowing English is important for moving up in school and also in the workplace. But millions of students in developing countries have little or no chance for a quality English language education. This is especially true in Indonesia, the world's fourth most populous country. Indonesia has hundreds of languages and ethnic groups spread across thousands of islands. For most people, the Indonesian national language is also a second language. But the nation's young people are hungry to learn a third language, English. English can be heard in coffee shops and shopping malls in the capital, Jakarta. Many of Jakarta's well-educated people mix English with Indonesian when talking with others. But outside of the city and the island of Bali, learning English can be a struggle. It is even more difficult for young people who come from poor families or live on faraway islands. Enter the English Access Micro Scholarship Program, an after-school English class. Known simply as Access, the program receives money from the United States Department of State. Access provides 2 years of free English classes to needy young people around the world. One of the largest Access programs is in Indonesia, with about 1,000 students. Earlier this year, several American English teachers organized a series of English language summer camps across Indonesia. The teachers wanted to show that learning English could be fun.
Students enjoy getting to know Americans firsthand, and it provides the Americans an opportunity to really get to know the culture of the students and also to understand firsthand some of the problems that these kids and their families face in their communities.
For most of the Indonesian students, it was the first time they had ever met an American or spent a night away from home. Tabitha Kidwell helped plan the camp activities.
They really enjoyed learning about multiculturalism in America. They love, of course, learning to make friendship bracelets and learning to play different American games. And they really enjoy the self-reflective workshops that we do, too.
One of the most popular workshops was on American English pronunciations. Christy Lewis is an English language fellow from Tennessee.
The workshop teaches the kids about rhythm of the American English language and starts introducing them to how to speak more native-like.
Kids go to camp, the kids go to the camp.
The kids are going to the camp, the kids are going to the camp, the kids are going to the camp.
Brian Holzer is from a small farm town in Wisconsin. He spoke with the Indonesian teenagers about the game of American football.
It's interesting. At first when I showed them the ball, they all said rugby. But once I taught them about the rules, the basic idea of the sport, they became more interested in American football.
What we do here in Indonesia is we sing a lot at our Access camps. The kids absolutely love to sing, and they love learning new songs.
Thumbs up!
Thumbs up!
Elbows back!
Elbows back!
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling!
The campers closed a long day of activities with a campfire. Faisal Zakaria is an English teacher from Banda Aceh. in Indonesia's northwest. He studied in the United States on a Fulbright exchange program. He hopes the camp will motivate his students to dream big and be more open-minded.
I see my lecturers, my teachers, graduated from American University, and they talk about America, traveling here and there, and it really makes me like, if he could do it, I can do it. Shoot for the moon. Even if you fail, you land among the stars.
The program was not just Americans teaching about U.S. culture. The students also shared local songs and dances with the American teachers. On the eastern island of Ambon, students prepared an English translation of a favorite folk song. The camps lasted only 3 days, yet some teachers noticed a change in their students during that period. Mutiati Ranti is a lecturer at the University of Indonesia. She helped plan the camps. She says one of the goals was to assist mutual understanding between Americans and Indonesians.
Before the camps, the kids might have thought that Americans are difficult to approach. They are superiors to others, and they might have negative opinions toward Muslims. But through the experience during the camps, then they know that Americans are just like them. Through the interactions during the camp, then they learn that Americans are very friendly and that what they thought earlier was wrong.
I wanted to thank Access because honestly before I joined Access, I really hate English because I always get remedial in my subject in my school about the English, and I don't know. After I joined Access, I completely changed, and I don't know why, but I like it, and I like English, and I realize about how important that for me.